All right, you guys, today we're talking festivals, shows, touring, and cameras. A lot of you guys, if you don't know, I shoot a lot of bands live, music videos, festivals, and I've done touring as well. So today I'm gonna show you guys what I use, how I use it, and some tips on shooting concerts, you know, dealing with all the different changes in lighting and scenarios and all that. So let's get right into it. When I first started, I started on a refurbished Sony A6000 that I bought off of Amazon for like $400 or something like that. And it was like a big purchase for me at the time. And I was just like, whoa, like that's like, I'm spending that much on a camera. I don't even know if I'm gonna like this. I bought that camera and the rest is history. I started using it more and more. I started getting super into video and photos and I was just loving the whole process. And because I started shooting bands and all that. And at the time my work wasn't great, but people were telling me like, oh, that's good. Like, this is great. You should continue doing this. And I was like, oh, cool. Yeah, you know, I guess I know what I'm doing. I watched like 2 YouTube videos. I should know what I'm doing. So before we even get into gear and how I set up my cameras and settings, there's a couple of things I want to talk to you guys about on what to expect and kind of like some tips on shooting if you're going to get into concert photography or videography. So one of the main things I get asked by a lot of people is, how do I get into video or photo photography for concerts? The one thing I always tell people is you just got to get out and shoot. Go shoot the local bars, the local venues, the small venues, because you don't really need passes or anything like that. Most of the time the shows are free, or a lot of the times the bands or artists are accessible enough to get passes and you can go shoot photos for them. Any artist or band will love free photos, and that's a great way to get started and start getting experience, start getting a feel for what it's like to be at the shows, and start learning your gear a lot more. The more you will learn your gear, the more you will learn your camera and how it works and how it handles low light. It's just gonna get you ready for, you know, the future if that's what you're trying to do. Now, like I said, most of the time you will need a photo pass or a all access pass from one of the artists if it is a bigger venue or bigger artist. Like I said, smaller venues usually don't require it. You can kind of just show up and shoot from the crowd or no problem. But when you're dealing with mid-sized venues or bigger arenas or things like that, you definitely need a photo pass. Or if you are working with an artist directly, you will get an all access pass. A lot of the mid-sized venues to bigger venues will only allow you a 3-song limit, which is usually the first 3 songs. So be aware of that if that is your situation. But a lot of times when you're shooting with certain artists, to say if you're shooting the headliner, you can be around in the pit or on the stage for as long as you need to be, as long as you have all access pass. Now you might be thinking, how do I get a photo pass? How do I get an all access pass? A lot of times for me, I've been hit up by the bands and the bands will provide me a photo pass or a ticket for the show or an all access pass. But in other occasions, sometimes you can reach out to the promoters or the venues or whoever's in charge, maybe sometimes tour managers or whatever, of the bands that are coming through your city and ask them for a photo pass. A lot of times they will want to see your work or they want to see a portfolio and they will tell you if you can shoot or not. So when you're out shooting at concerts, you have to be a ninja. You have to be quick. You have to be on your toes. You have to be fast. And you have to be mindful of other people around you, including the artist. When you're in the pit, there's going to be a lot of other photographers or videographers doing their job as well. So you have to respect them and hopefully they respect you. You don't want to be seen as much. Wear stage blacks. Usually when I go and shoot, I wear all black if I can, because if you're on stage, you can hide a little more, you can blend a little more, you're not really seen. Another quick tip when you're out shooting at the show, get creative. Think about different angles, different perspectives. You wanna get the viewer feeling like they are at the show. So sometimes I'll shoot right up on the stage and I'll go back in the crowd and I'll shoot in between the crowd or through the crowd and I'll go get a really wide shot if I'm like in an arena. If you have all access, get on stage, get the drummers, get different perspectives that you can think of on the spot and just try to get it. I know sometimes it's hard if you only have a 3-song limit at certain venues, but once that 3-song limit is over, it doesn't mean you're done shooting. You can go around the venue and shoot from different angles depending on what lenses you have, but just get creative with your shots. So yeah, like I said, those are all like pretty quick tips before you even grab your camera and go out to shoot. Just be mindful of all those things. And there's a lot going on where there's concert or an event or whatever. There's a lot of people working together to make this thing happen, and then you're included in there as well. You're gonna be running around. Just be mindful of all those things and you will be fine. And always be respectful to everybody. You don't want to be kicked out. Be respectful with the artists. Hopefully they're respectful to you. Most of the time they will be, because they're probably hiring you. And I just be respectful to everybody, security and everybody. You'll have a good time. All right, so I'm gonna tell you guys the gear that I use. I have a list right here because I have a terrible memory, so I'm gonna go down the list. For camera bodies, I have a Sony a7 III, and most recently added the Sony a7C, which has kind of become my main camera for everything lately, just because of the compact size, but also because the Sony a7 III is all rigged up in the cage and all that, and sometimes I don't want to carry that heavier camera, so I have the a7C. The a7C, I feel like, is perfect for concerts and events because it's small, you can just carry it. So yeah, the Sony a7C has been one of my favorite bodies, camera bodies to carry, one of my favorite bodies to carry around. I don't carry bodies around, trust me. One of my favorite camera bodies to carry around for events. As far as lenses, I have the Tamron 28-75mm 2.8. I know it's not the widest aperture, but it does the job, especially with Sony being able to handle low light very well. It's great. Very versatile. You can go wide, you can go tight, all the way to 75. I have the Sigma 16mm 1.4, which is a great wide-angle lens and a wide aperture to get the most light in as possible. That's great if you're like in the right in front of the stage and you're shooting up and you can get wider shots, or if you're behind a drummer or anything like that, it's a great lens to have for that. And the next lens is the Sony 85mm f1.8, which is one of my favorite lenses of all time. I think that lens can make anything look great. That's a great lens to shoot from like the crowd or even from the pit if you have enough space. Everything looks great on that lens. I love how it looks in video and photo. For accessories, I do have a gimbal. I used to use a Weeble S. I think it was. I remember the Weeble S, but I just recently upgraded that to the Ronin RS2, which is one of my favorite gimbals of all time. It's great. I use that depending on the type of shoot it is, or event or venue. Most recently, like, I went out to the UK with Zebrahead, was doing some music video stuff for them, so obviously I want to get some smooth, steady shots. And then I have my camera in a small rig cage so that I can mount the monitor on there, or mics, or anything else that I need. Super handy to have on your camera. And obviously a camera bag, or a small camera bag to have. You want to carry all your stuff on you, because if you're going to be running around festival grounds or arena or venue, you need to change lenses real quick. You want to be able to have everything on you, unless there's an area. Sometimes in the pit you can leave your stuff, but I wouldn't recommend it. People can just grab it and take it. But if you have access on the stage or backstage, you can leave your bag and be switching out stuff like that. But if you're going to be running out front, take some other lenses with you so that you can change your lenses and get creative with your shots. Let's get into how I set up the cameras. Okay, so first things first, make sure you are in manual mode, no shooting in auto, no auto modes, no nothing like that. You have to have full control of your camera. For your aperture on your lenses, set it as wide open as your lens goes. So in my case, my Sigma is the one that goes the lowest, which is 1.4, and it's gonna allow the most light into your camera, especially if you're in a venue, because most venues are dark as hell. And the only light there is from the show while the show is going on. So shoot as wide open as you can. For focus, I set mine to autofocus. The Sony A7 III and A7C are pretty great for the most part, especially in low light. So if you have a camera that is great with autofocus, then go for it. A lot of these settings are for video, and I'll get into some photo settings, which is not much different. There's only a couple things that will be different for a photo, but most of the next things that we'll be talking about are for video. For video, I make sure I am in a picture profile, whether it be HLG or S-Log. I usually use HLG because it's a very versatile picture profile. HLG makes it easy to just film, put it into editing, and not have to do much with color grading and all that. Obviously you can, but it makes it out of the camera footage looks great. I know a lot of people shoot in log. If that's what you shoot in, that's fine, but you wanna be able to have the most dynamic range that you can, because during a concert, there are so many lighting changes, so many things going on, that you wanna have your camera set up to be able to capture all that. For frame rate, I will set it to 60 frames per second. For the most part, that's usually what I'm at. I don't wanna go to 120 because then I have to crank my shutter even more, and I don't wanna get less light into my sensor. So 60 frames per second is fine. And then it allows me to slow footage down if I need to in post. For white balance, for the most part, I just set it to daylight and move on from that. It's usually, there's so much color change and lighting changes during a show that it's impossible to just guess a right white balance. So for ISO, a lot of times I'll set it to auto as well, and I'll set the lowest parameter to 100 and the highest like 3200, maybe 6400, depending on your camera, if you know your camera can handle higher ISOs. If not, 3200 is still pretty good and usable for a lot of video cameras. For shutter speed as well, this is one that I will change a lot of the times as I go, especially if I'm outdoors. If you don't have a variable ND filter, which I don't, which I ordered one and should be here eventually. I don't know, it's a Freewell one, the magnet ones. It'd take forever to get here, but I don't have an ND filter as of right now. So I'll switch my shutter speed while I'm shooting, but if you're inside a venue, for the most part, that kind of might stay in the same spot. You never want to go below the 180 degree rule for video. So if your frame rate is at 60, you want to be at like 1/25th of a second and not go below that. Obviously, if you're at 24, you want to be at 1/50th of a second and not go below that. You can go higher, but you can't go below because you're going to get really choppy footage. Keep that in mind. So for photo settings, everything is pretty much the same. The shutter speed, I do want to start my shutter speed at 1/250th and up. You don't want to shoot a little lower than that because you will get a lot of motion blur unless that's something you're looking to get in the photo because it's like a creative thing. But if you want to get some sharp images, 1/250th a second on shutter speed is a great spot to start, and then move up from there if you need to crank that shutter. And also for photos, very important, make sure you are shooting in RAW. This is similar to shooting in a picture profile, but for photos, you're going to get the most dynamic range out of RAW photo rather than the JPEG, so that when you take it into editing, especially for concerts and things like this, sometimes you get a shot that the lighting wasn't great and it might be too dark or it might be too bright. But if you're shooting in RAW, you can fix that or try to save it in Lightroom or Photoshop and compensate. If it's too dark, bring up those shadows. If it's too bright, bring down those highlights, and you can get an awesome picture. So make sure you are shooting in RAW. And also, white balance for photos, you can run auto on white balance. But yeah, you guys, this is a quick video I wanted to make on how, what I use and how I set it up, and just some tips on shooting concert photography or video if that's what you're trying to get into. And like I always tell everybody, don't be scared. Just go out and meet the bands, meet the artists in your local venues or anything like that. And just tell them, hey, can I shoot some photos of you guys for free? And I'll send them to you guys tomorrow or the end of the night, whatever. And just get out there and start shooting. Just, that's what you got to do. That's what I did in the beginning. But the point is to start doing it and get your work out there. That's just the main thing I tell everybody. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoy that. If you guys have any questions, leave them in the comments below. I'm pretty sure I missed a lot of things that I could talk about in this video. Like I said, I'm still learning every day. I'm sure there's a lot of other people that do this for a living and they know a lot more than me. But this is just from my experiences or the things I do and how they've worked for me. So, you know, I just want to share it with you because it maybe helps you. Because I remember when I started in the beginning, it was just all like a blur to me. I didn't really know what the hell I was doing. And still, sometimes I don't know what the hell I'm doing. But yeah, I hope you guys got something out of it. And if you guys liked it, give it a like, maybe subscribe. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.